Operation CARE has discovered a way to try to meet the needs of others in real tangible ways. Join us as we discover together how we can be a part of what God is doing in our community.
There's no one like you, Jesus.
The year was 1988 that God gave me a burden for hurting people. So my husband and I began collecting food and clothing, and Operation CARE was born. It all started in this house in the 800 block of Main Street, and the people came.
You open up.
And the scripture that the Lord gave me was Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed and qualified me to preach the gospel of good tidings to the meek, the poor, and afflicted. He has sent me to bind up and heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the physical and spiritual captives, and the opening of the prison and of the eyes to those who are bound. In 1990, God enlarged that vision, and we moved to our present location, which is on the corner of 8th and Washington Street. I saw four areas: evangelism, healing, physical assistance, and deliverance. God's been so faithful throughout the years, and many people have caught the vision. My son Kevin joined me to help me keep up with an ever-growing ministry. In 1998, the Mercy Medical Clinic was born through a vision from Dr. Tom O'Neill, who immediately tapped Dr. Dennis Kinlaw to help.
Hi, I'm Dennis Kinlaw. I've been coming to Mercy Medical for the last 8 to 10 years. Most of my life I've lived out of self-interest, and the clinic's been a great way for him to just diagnostically look at my motives, to try to be his eyes and see these people the way he sees them.
The scripture tells us very specifically we're to serve, not to be served, and we should think of others, obviously, before we think of ourselves. So here I am, 4.5 years later, after retirement, thinking I'm going to be having a life of leisure, and I'm extremely busy right now at Mercy Medical Clinic and loving every minute of it.
We are a fully volunteer-operated organization, and we provide health care for uninsured families and dental care for uninsured children. Our services at Mercy Medical Clinic would not be possible without the support of our Shelbyville community and our many volunteers, as well as local organizations and businesses such as United Way.
About 3 years ago, I was homeless. I was on the street. And I was walking down the street one day, and matter of fact, right here, I was walking right here, and I was like, God, what am I going to do? I don't know what to do no more. I need help, but I don't know who to ask. It felt like somebody was just pulling me in by my shoulder and saying, go in here, go in here, go in here. So I walked in and I talked to Lisa. And Lisa said, I know we can help you.
In 2005, Kevin and I turned the leadership of Operation CARE over to Judy Roberts.
It's only by the power of the cross I'm raised. The King of Glory.
Hey, we're here at Operation CARE on the 8th Street entrance, and we're excited to hear from Judy Roberts, who is the actual executive director of what happens here. And Judy has developed an awesome passion to reach people that are in need, to do good and to share with others. Judy, tell us about the heart of Operation CARE.
The heart of Operation CARE is showing the love and compassion of Jesus Christ to hurting people.
Right. So you are passionate about meeting people's needs where they are, and you've got a variety of ways you do that.
Shelter, food, clothes, furniture, rental assistance, utility assistance, homeless prevention. 2008, we helped over 4,000 people. And so far for 2009, our numbers are far going to exceed 2008. We have many more clients than we have staff here. We find here at Operation Care that as we meet their tangible needs, we also discover that they have spiritual needs. Operation Care's mission field is the streets of Shelby County.
The heart of Operation Care is giving and helping. God has really just over the years just provided for this ministry in such a way that it's awesome. And it's a faith build. I find it to be good for my faith because I see God actually working within this this ministry.
What we do is house women and children which are homeless and assist them to reach self-sufficiency. Do they have their GED? Do they have their children in daycare? Do they have a job, a car? And we start working on the basics. We are the only agency in Shelby County that are providing a home for homeless women, a shelter, a safe spot. There are other agencies that provide funds for prevention to help with utilities and rent, but we are the only one that can provide a home for those women and children.
I have two children. I had lost my job and lost my apartment, and we needed some clothing and some food. So I came to Operation Care, and they were here for us and helped us out with all of our needs. Operation Care was here for us, and they helped us out. And now that we're doing well, I'm back here, and I'm volunteering and trying to help other people. I just think it's a great place to be.
This is an emergency.
Here is to help people that's in need due to crisis situations. Some of them will come in and they just need a few groceries. Some may be homeless and need a warm place to stay. Some people may come in and their home burned to the ground and they're in need of household items, furniture, and other items. So we're here to fill in that gap, to show them that someone cares and to show the love of Jesus. We're always in need of a good food drive from churches and other places and organizations. As long as they keep doing that, you know, we can be able to help needy people. When people come to us and they're in need, you know, we need to be able to meet their needs. We know God's going to, you know, answer our prayers. At Operation Care, we do good and share with others.
As the need has grown, Operation Care continues to meet those needs because God has made the provision.
Blood flows down, blood flows down, flowing from the hands of the healer. Death is bound.
We challenge you to join Operation Care outside of the gates and into our community.
So beautiful, oh, so beautiful, so beautiful your love. Glory to the King who gave his life.